Brian, Cleveland, you're on the Savage Nation. Go ahead, please.
Yeah, I'm a socialist. I believe in socialism. And
well, of course you do. You're a loser who can't make anything on his own, so you want it from me. What else is new?
How much? Do you know how much money Bill Gates has? I mean, he doesn't.
Well, who'd he take it from, you?
He doesn't need $55 billion.
What do you mean he doesn't need it? Who'd he take it from, you?
He didn't take it from anybody, but he's...
How much taxes does he pay a year? How much in taxes do you think he pays a year?
I have no idea.
Of course you have no idea, because you're a dummy. How could you have an idea? He pays, and so do the people who make more than $1 million a year, about 90% of all the federal income tax in this country. Did you know that? Without us, you'd wind up eating mites in the street.
Do you know how much food corporations waste, like Procter & Gamble, when they make...
food? You're telling me there are skinny homeless people in America who are starving to death?
Yeah, but
have you ever taken a look at the people on welfare lately, the size of them?
You can take that food.
They're fat as horses because they have too much to eat and not enough to do, but knock out babies and collect welfare. What are you talking about? Let me repeat the hard data, my friend. The people who earn over $1 million a year provide over 90% of all of the federal income tax in this country. The people who earn over $1 million a year support men like you. Have a nice day. Three in a row now. Let's go for a 10-pin shot. They don't like it. They want of course they want socialism. Wouldn't you want socialism if you were either genetically damaged or you were a drunk or an alcoholic or a drug addict or stupid or lazy? And you wanted somebody to just pay you to sit at home? Of course you'd want socialism. Sure you'd want socialism. You could sit at home and play dominoes like they do in Cuba in ripped undershirts with 1954 Buicks. That's what you get with socialism. See, I don't want to sit home and play dominoes. I could have retired years ago, but I won't retire because I believe in borders, language, and culture. I also believe in fair play. And I also believe in being paid for your work and not being taxed to death in order to support deadbeat bums and illegal aliens. And that's what makes me... That's what makes me a popular talk show host, because I actually represent the working man in America, by the way. They don't like when they hear reality. They're so used to having spoon-fed pablum from the politicians who are telling them they're all wonderful. They walk around with the smiles, and they tell them that they're oppressed minorities or underprivileged whites, and the rich corporations are stealing from them. And when they become a president or whatever they're going to become, they're going to balance the scales out. Yeah. And, of course, they've got the useful idiots out there believing them. But when they hear the realities and they have to look nakedly at the statistics of, A, who pays the taxes here, and, B, what the illegal aliens have done to our country, of course they're going to get mad at me. I have told you before, sometimes medicine tastes lousy. In fact, good medicine always tastes lousy. Old Doc Savage gives you the pill that you need in order to get straight. That pill tastes lousy. I don't sugarcoat my words. You want sugarcoating? Go to Hillary or Obama.
Savage.